Hey fellow comrades, boys in here, and today we are on Facebook. Now I've mentioned this before, and I'm gonna be doing a special shout out to a special someone that decided to take his efforts. Actually, there were lots of people that took its efforts, but I don't have enough time to give everybody appropriate shout out, but I can at least pick one random one and give it a shout out to. So in this case, we're gonna pick let's pick this guy, Sean OCC. Thank you for your time and your efforts, man. I appreciate it. The votings, of course, you guys can be a part of. You can just go on my Facebook, like me on Facebook, and this is something I'm going to be doing every now and again. I'm going to put a certain trainer, a certain person in the Pokemon world, going against another certain person in Pokemon world, both of them dueling it out in fame, and the person that people found it most interesting, or they favoritized that single person based on their teams and so forth, that person is going to be used in my, you know, the one that gets the most comment votes is going to be used in my next match. So in this case, this is going to be the team I shall be using. Everything is going to go outside of their items. The items is something I'm going to gain, but everything else is going to be original by their standards. So with that being said, let's go directly into our first match. Okay, here we are. Now this is going to be 3-on-3. It's going to be single match environment, and I've decided to be playing a little bit more offensive. So what I did was I actually picked Metagross, Aggron, and one more offensive Pokemon, if I'm not mistaken. I believe it's Armaldo. Yeah, that's like the most offensive you can pick from my team. Because if 3-on-3, you really cannot play as much defensive as you want, just because it heavily depends on the team the opponent is facing, you know, the opponent is using. Not to mention that 3-on-3, there is really, you know, a certain limit of defense you can play. After that, you really gotta be dishing out some damage at the same time, and it's all about who takes who down. Anyways, in the first couple of turns, my opponent was extremely lucky, and I didn't really have a solid switch to Thunder, so I had to sack him after that, unfortunately. Now, it managed to balance itself out by letting him miss his Thunder there. That was actually pretty great, and for all you guys don't know, actually, I was running Choice Band at Metagross back there, back then. Still, he's gonna go for Shell Smash. I'm thinking, okay, Focus Blast, not really, not really. Steven's got that Power Herb, Solar Beam, ladies and gentlemen. It is incredible. Oh my god, Steven, you got yourself some style, man. You may have your bulk, you may have strength, but you got some special attack on top. Like, who's gonna expect special attack in Aggron, for god's sake? That's a whole new level. Nobody expects that. Nobody normal, at least. Razor Shell, I believe that's called. And then again, I'm probably mistaken. Anyways, Dragon Claw is gonna be enough. I do have Sturdy. I guess he was expecting me to run the ability that prevents me from getting the recoil from the moves, such as Head Smash and the likes of that. But that was pretty incredible. His Arcanine, his last remaining, is gonna come in. He's gonna go for the Outrage directly for his strongest move. And I guess it does make sense. Metagross was taken down, Aggron was taken down, whatever else I have is probably not a Steel type, and it's probably not a Skarmory. So he had it planned out very well. She may have, you know, it depends if it's a she or he, but let's address it as a she. She had it planned out quite well there. I'm gonna go for the Ancient Power Expert Belted. Unfortunately, it's not enough, and I'm guessing it's banded just because the sheer damage it's got, and Outrage is only resisted by the likes of Steel. So again, that was a very planned out, very well planned out move. Now, unfortunate, well, Flare Blitz could have been a problem towards me, but then again, I could have taken it. I have the ability that prevents the crits from happening. So at the end of the day, it was a very, very solid match that came down to be a slight 1-0 score into my favor. Anyways, this was actually my second match. It was actually a rotation match, and it took forever to get in here. Like, it took me 20 minutes to get a player on search. That was pretty incredible. Anyways, we got ourselves some very masochistic Pokemon to face. Like, so many fire abusers, it's ridiculous. Still, I'm gonna switch out directly, rotate into Claydol, because I want my light screen to be up there so I can appropriately manage this guy to handle. Plus, I'm kind of hoping he doesn't have Dark Pulse. He does decide to go for the Outrage, and I was actually starting to ask myself, well, does Outrage actually, you know, lock him into keep on outraging, or can he still freely, you know, rotate into something else? But from the performance on the next turn, I'm starting to believe that he can't do anything on that particular turn until he actually gets confused. Then again, I may still be mistaken. Well, either way, I guess this would directly rotate into my Skarmory and go for the Toxic, as I do have, I actually have Kenzai. I'm starting to give him thinking that I may have Sturdy, so I guess that's why he didn't directly switch out to his Typhlosion. But his Ember is gonna go for the... What was that? Like, I believe that move is based on the heavy, you know, the heaviness, the lighter the Pokemon comparing to you, the more the damage is gonna be doing. Or is it the other way around? That the more the heavier you are, the more damage you're gonna be doing. The heavier the opponent is, the more damage it's gonna be doing. That may just be. Well, either way, it didn't really do much against Metagross, and I can appropriately semi-handle that by switching out to Skarmory, and I did appropriately make a right move there. But I'm gonna directly switch out to my Claydol, as I did get speed up right there from my ancient power boost. I can manage to outspeed his inboard. That was incredible. But afterwards, he's gonna switch out directly, rotate into his Typhlosion, and go for the eruption. Easy, clean KO. That is actually very detrimental. This thing is a threat. Still, I can semi-manage it with my Aggron, ladies and gentlemen. He's gonna go for the eruption. I was actually expecting him to rotate into his Scimitar to go for the likes of Surf or Earthquake or maybe even Earth Power, which I'm heavily more weak to it. But the guy unfortunately stays in, definitely something I was not expecting, but still, you know, that's why I actually managed to go for the Solar Beam. Fortunately, at least we can say, you know, because he didn't switch out, at least we did get a crit, which is actually very important, because when somebody runs Eruption and it spams against your team, it depends on his HP how much damage that's gonna be doing. But with the help of Ancient Power's special defense boost, I'm starting to believe that my Claydol can still manage to take on this, and I do luckily manage to take on the likes of Eruption at that amount of HP he was at. So that was pretty incredible, taken down with another Earthquake. Claydol pretty much taking down all them fire type Pokemon, but this time he's actually gonna miss the Fire Blast if I'm not mistaken, and the next turn I believe, if I'm not mistaken, he's gonna hit himself. So luck is really going to my favor. I believe this player had a score of 651 wins, which is actually very crazy considering that to find a rotation match, I guess early stage in Pokemon Black and White it was much easier to find, but now it's like it's really hard to find them, you know. Anyways, I'm going for the Earthquake, and it luckily did pay off to a certain extent because he did switch out to his Scimitar. So I guess at the end of the day, not much has been lost. As well as we do have Light Screen, as well as Reflect up there. We do have the bulk to semi-manage them both. Hopefully that's still the case here, because Scimitar can be a problem. But then again, we do have Reflect, and he's gonna go for a Drain Punch, which based on the damage that did, I'm pretty sure I could have taken his Stab Earthquake from the amount of HP I'm at. I mean, Drain Punch didn't do anything. So Earthquake still being super effective, I'm still pretty sure I could have taken it with slight HP remaining, taken down clean. That was surprising, but Choice Bandit Metagross is extremely powerful. That's a resisted hit, yet it's still clean taken down at that amount of HP. That was crazy. Anyways, that was today's session, today's matches. One was singles and second one was rotation, of course. You know, Steven's team is actually very, very fun to use. It's actually very unbalancing. And I don't even know how I managed to take down those fire types at the beginning. That was ridiculous. But I hope you guys have enjoyed as much as I did. If you did, please be sure to like this video. Thank you very much for the continued support. And again, guys, go check out my Facebook fan page where I'm taking all them votes for you guys. You know, you guys are the judgment. You know, in the future change depending on the trainer that gets the most votes in the comment sections on my Facebook fan page. But anyways, guys, until the next one, take care. Peace.